RobinReaction.com.
In this video, I'm going to go over how to calculate atomic mass. And this is for people who are just starting to do these problems. I'm going to do lots of different steps. If you are looking for help on a little bit more difficult problem of these, I have a video on that I'll link to as well. And so for now, let's go ahead and read this question. Magnesium has three naturally occurring stable isotopes. So I phrased it like this because you're going to see this phrasing in a lot of atomic mass questions. Naturally occurring just means it wasn't made in a lab, and stable just means it's not going to disappear after a couple of seconds. It's not radioactive. This is something where it's going to exist. So all you have to care about this first sentence is that magnesium has three isotopes that you have to care about. Don't worry about the rest of them. So now moving on. Magnesium-24 has a mass of 23.985 amu and 79% abundance, which means that 79% of magnesium atoms that exist on Earth have a mass of 23.985. Abundance is just, that's how much percent out of 100 this particular isotope has. And then we have magnesium-25 with a mass of 24.986 amu and a 10% abundance. And lastly, we have magnesium-26 with a mass of 25.983 amu and 11% abundance. So, what's the average atomic mass? That's usually how these problems go. So, number one, you always just want to line up all your isotope masses and match them with their percent. In this question, it's pretty easy. We were given all three masses and percents, but I think it can still help just to write it down visually on the page so we know we're not making a mistake. All right, so now we can clearly see what isotope goes with what percent. And so number two is basically just to set up a big math problem and then slowly solve. So we're going to multiply each isotope mass with its percent, and I like to write it as a fraction with a denominator of 100, and then we add each together. All right, so first I'm just going to write all of this down. So we have each isotope mass times its percent, which I like to write, just to avoid confusion, as a fraction with a denominator of 100. That way when I'm plugging in, I know I'm not going to get anything wrong or confused with my decimals. And then we're going to add that to each other isotope. Okay, so now I'm just going to go ahead and follow PEMDAS until I get my answer. So my first thing I'm going to do is go ahead and get rid of doing my percents as a fraction, go ahead and turn it into a decimal. Okay, so now I'm going to take these and go ahead and multiply, just because that comes before addition in PEMDAS. All right, and now I can go ahead and add all of these sums together. I get 24.3049, and let's go ahead and do sig figs and also just kind of think about, does our answer make sense before we get our final answer. So for sig figs, it's gonna be everything we were given in the original question. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3. So 3 sig figs is our limitation. So we're going to be limited to 1, 2, 3. So our final answer is 24.3. Our unit is still AMU. And let's go ahead and just make sure this makes sense. So if we look at our original isotope masses, 23.9, we had 24.9. and 25.9. And so we know that our lightest one is 23.9, and that takes up the most. That's almost 80% of the isotopes. So it makes sense that our answer is pretty close to 23.9. It's just a little bit higher than that because we had 10% and 11% of higher isotopes. So this checks out, and this is my average atomic mass. All right, so let's go ahead and do another problem that's a little bit different. Boron has two naturally occurring stable isotopes, so again, basically saying, in this problem, we're only going to care about two isotopes. Boron-10 has a mass of 10.013 AMU, Boron 11 has a mass of 11.009 AMU. The lighter isotope has an abundance of 20%. What is the average atomic mass? All right, so again, we start by just lining up all the isotope masses with their percentage. So we have our two masses, and now we have to do a little bit of figuring out to get the percentages. So it says the lighter isotope has an abundance of 20%. So the lighter one is just our first one that weighs 10.013. And it didn't give us anything for the other isotope, but we can figure it out because we know overall the percentage has to add up to 100%. And since there are only two things and the other one is 20%, we can solve and get that our abundance for the one that weighs 11 AMU is 80%. All right, so now that we have our isotope masses and their percents, let's go ahead and set up the same type of problem. We're going to multiply each isotope mass with its percent as a fraction with a denominator of 100, and we're going to add everything together. Okay, so first I'm just going to get my fractions out of, I'm going to get my percents out of fraction form into denominator form. And again, I know this step is tedious, but I will say it completely eliminates mistakes. So if you're someone that is getting your percents wrong and then making little mistakes, go ahead and go back to this method and it will eliminate you ever doing that. All right, and now we can go ahead and multiply. And now we can go ahead and add together. And now this is our answer before sig figs and units. So let's go ahead and check for sig figs. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 1, 2, 3 sig figs. So our limitation is once again 3 sig figs. So we can keep to 1, 2, 3. This is our cutoff point. And we end up with 10.8 AMU. All right, hope this video helped you figure out some atomic mass calculation problems.
Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to like, comment, or subscribe. And if you go to my website, I have a ton of free practice problems you can check out. And if you need even more help, you can hire me for one-on-one private tutoring sessions that are online. All right, thanks, that's it. Happy studying.